guys, it's Kristen. Thank you for joining us for another video. Hopefully you will have come off of Angie Mason's premiere, which would have been right before mine. And before her was Lance Travis from Pouring Together with Lance Travis and Julie E before that. Thank you for joining us all this evening. Today I'm flying solo. Today's video is just me practicing some blooms on tiles. Hey guys, it's Kristen. So I'm back with my spinner, as you could see. I'm going to be doing some tiles. I have a new color palette that I want to test because I want to make, in addition to the coasters, a trivet and a cutting board. So I've already got my cutting board taped and I'll pour on the wooden piece. Either this one or I have a big one, this big one right here, that I'll be pouring in this area. I haven't decided which one I'm going to use yet, but that's my new project. So I'll run through my colors. It's a combination of some TLP pigments and some golden fluid acrylics. So I'll go through the goldens first. I have goldens, green gold, and to this I added just a tiny bit of iridescence to make it sparkly, and I added a little touch of yellow just to brighten it up a little bit. So that's goldens, green gold, and I mixed these using my Bloom Technique pouring medium, which is the Behr 8300 deep base, the Valspar Ultra in base C, and the Josonja gloss varnish. I do 3 to 3 to 2 parts, or 1 to 1 to 2/3. I like math, so it's easy for me to follow. If you're measuring out in cups, you could do 1 cup of the Behr, 1 cup of the Valspar, and 2/3 cups of the Josonja. And that's my pouring medium for both the fluid paints and the piggies. So with the fluid paints, I don't add any Josonja gloss varnish first. I just put the pouring medium and then the fluid paint right in there. So that's golden green. I also have golden turquoise Thalo, which is a gorgeous color that I mixed with the same pouring medium. You can see that, beautiful turquoise. And then I also have golden iridescent gold fine. And this is just a nice light gold color. Not too bright, a little bit subtle, which is kind of what I want. But you can see the consistency is just like leaving a mound, but then it sinks right in. It's so creamy. I don't know how else to describe it. It's great. All right, so those are my golden colors. And then for my pickies, I have TLP Sapphire. So now when I mix these up, I coated the bottom. These are the little 2 ounce baby cups from the Fluid Art Co. site. I coat the bottom with a layer of Josonja gloss varnish, maybe a couple of milliliters worth. Then I put in a hefty little scoop of the pigment to wet it, make sure that it's all wet, and then I add my pouring medium. So this I mixed up a couple of days ago, so it definitely needs to be reconstituted because there was a haze on the top there. But it's very nice and creamy and a gorgeous deep blue color. It's lovely. Then I have some cinnamon, which is also Jeremy Massey's stripper name. You guys have watched the Massey Art Studio videos with the TLPs. they talked about that. So this is Cinnamon, and it is just gorgeous. Like, look at that. Look at how shimmery that is, and it's so velvety smooth with this PM. Oh, just absolutely gorgeous. And then I have Sea Glass, another one of my faves. Like I said, I mixed these 2 days ago. When I mixed them up, they were filled with bubbles. Now, 2 days later, they are just smooth and gorgeous. I love this color, it's so pretty. So that's the Sea Glass. And then I have King of Payne, which is their version of Payne's Gray. So just mix it lightly just to make sure it's all even and smooth. So that's the paint. It's a very deep, dark blue gray color. And then finally, I have one of the interference pickies. This is Pinot Gris. I don't know how you say it. Pinot Gris. It's an interference, which means it looks white at first glance. When you get it on the canvas, and especially when it's dry and you tilt it out, it will shift. This is like a greenish gold shift. Probably not gonna be able to see it here in the camera. Maybe if I do this, I don't know. But it definitely shifts when it's dry. Okay, so I pretty much have them set out the way I wanna layer them. So I'm gonna do a tester on a tile. My pillow paint is just straight up house paint out of the jar. I mean, can. It is the Glidden Interior Exterior. This one is a gloss because I didn't know better when I bought it that the recommended was either an eggshell or a satin. So my next can is eggshell, and I'll be using that, but I haven't opened it yet. So I'm having a hard time unscrewing the bottle, so I'm not going to take the cap off. I'm just squirting it out. So I'm just putting a little bit on the bottom of the tile to help it stick onto the spinner. And I get it centered. And then I just wipe it down with a paper towel. I don't do anything special to treat it. I'm sorry for the shaking. Okay. I haven't done these in a while. I've done so many of them for Christmas gifts, and I just kind of didn't want to do any. Oh, and my cell activator, I forgot to mention, is Amsterdam Prussian Blue, and it is 3 parts Aussie Floetrol to 1 part paint. So that's my cell activator. So let's get some pillow down. Let's see if I can remember how to do this. It's been so long. Oh, and you know what? I'm gonna get my skewer so that I can make modifications and pop bubbles. Okay. All right, so I think I'm gonna layer them down in this order, starting with the TLP Sapphire. And I don't have to use a lot because I got a lot of colors here. I gotta remember that. And then the golden, green gold. Then the golden turquoise Thalo. I'm not used to using these spoons either, but I'm trying to not use so many stir sticks. And then the golden iridescent gold fine. This is going to be way too much paint. And then some of the King of Payne. Well, I'll learn for the next tile not to put so much. Okay. And then the Pinot. This is the interference. And then I'm gonna go with the Sea Glass. And then to top it off, the cinnamon. All right, let's pop these bubbles. Get it centered. Okay. And put our cell activator in the middle. Got my trusty straw, which I use just to spread out the cell activator a little bit. A bubble in there. It's okay. So cool. I don't know if I'm loving the green gold in there, so I may omit it next time. We'll see. All right, just gonna do a few little mods here. This area is so pretty, but I'm gonna swirl it anyway. That's nice. Well, everything else I like except this area here. Yeah, I think I'm gonna leave the green gold out next time. For sure. And I'm just using the paint that's already fallen off to use as a flow extender in the corners and on the sides. And then I will go over to my spinner box. All right, so let's give this a spin and see what happens. She was in love with a boy, in love with a girl, so in love with the world, so beautiful. She was in love with the light, the way the sun shines. All she needed was love to have to hold, and nobody could make her feel down. She was always smiling from ear to ear, and everybody wondered. Lift it up and see if I could give you all a close up. That's kind of cool. All right. Time to do another test. All right. I'm going to give this angle a try. Even though I think my phone is upside down, that's okay. All right. So I'm changing my order up a little bit. And I'm definitely going to use less paint this time because I'm not used to using these spoons, like I said. So I was getting way more paint on there than I really wanted. So this time we'll start out with the Sapphire, just like last time. Then I'm going to go in with the Pinot right after that. And then the Turquoise Thalo. And then the Gold. And then the Panes. Better already. Sea Glass. And then a little touch of the green gold, because I think I put way too much in there yesterday, and I really just want a little tiny flavor of it. Okay, and then the cinnamon. Okay. I don't see any bubbles. RCA down. Let it sink a little bit. Oh, I don't know if I'm going to be able to blow this out with the camera so close. I'll try. Love the middle. I will find a way to modify it. I think I'll come right through here. I really love all the other areas. Let's swirl this around a little bit. I don't have a lot of extra paint. I didn't use a lot of pillow. So let's put some extra. All right, let's give it a spin. Zoomed in, I was there. Pretty cool looking. Okay, so here's one of the finished tiles. Has not been resined yet, but you can see just how beautiful those piggies are sparkling. It'll look gorgeous once resined, but I didn't get a chance to resin it before the video. So I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you again for joining us. If you have not already subscribed, please consider subscribing to our channel. Leave us a comment. We'd love to hear from you. Thanks again for joining us. And until next time, everybody, have a good night. And until next week, take care. Bye.